Here's a chapter for you from your book Honeydew. That's the second chapter and is titled as The Tsunami. A tsunami is a very large and powerful wave caused by earthquakes under the sea. On 26 December 2004, a tsunami hit Thailand and parts of India, such as the Andaman and Nicobar Islands and the Tamil Nadu coast. So here are some stories of courage and survival. These stories are from Andaman and Nicobar archipelago. What do you mean by archipelago? It means a group of many islands and the surrounding sea. First, Ignatius was the manager of a cooperative society in Cachal. His wife woke him up early in the morning when she felt the earth shaking. She put the television down to save it from damage and the family ran out. They saw the waves looming ahead as the sea rose up. Each of them ran in terror in different directions. His wife, her mother and brother and the two children were swept away. Oh no, Ignatius lost his entire family to the tsunami that morning. Next person, Sanjeev, a policeman. He was able to save himself. Anyhow, his wife and the little daughter from those giant waves. He then jumped into the roaring water to save the wife of his guest house cook John. But unfortunately, Sanjeev and the woman both were swept away. Third, Meghna. She was also swept away by the waves along with her parents and 77 other people. Spending 2 days on the sea, she floated on a wooden door. She could not be spotted by rescue helicopters. Rescue helicopters could not recognize where was she. But a wave pushed her ashore and she was saved. So she was definitely the fortunate survivor. Next was Almaz Javed, who was 10 years old. She was a student of Carmel Convent in Port Blair, where her father had a petrol pump. Almaz and her family were sleeping when the tsunami struck. Her father woke up and saw water go back after the quake. He knew that it would return with powerful waves. He tried to take the family to higher ground for safety. As they ran, her grandfather fell down, and as father ran to help him up, a wave took both of them away. Her mother and aunts too were swept away with the tree which they hold on to. But Almaz climbed up on a floating log of wood and then fainted. She was rescued and regained consciousness in a hospital. She is still in shock. In the second part, you can see the picture of Tilly Smith. She was a British schoolgirl and was able to save many lives when the tsunami struck in Thailand. Though she has won a number of awards, her parents have not allowed their daughter to be interviewed on television and made into a heroine. Why they took such a decision? So here's a story from Thailand. Tilly came to Thailand to celebrate Christmas from England with her family. On December 26th, the family was on beach when the sea began to rise up. Tilly remembered her geography lesson from school and sensed something wrong. You see that how your lessons, your chapter which you read at school sometimes help you at the moment. Similar thing happened with her. The sea started to foam and form whirlpools. Foam means bubbling and whirlpool means water moving in quick circular motion. Chili's mother didn't know what was happening, but Chili recalled the video her teacher had shown in the class a few weeks ago. She knew these were certain signs of coming tsunami. She shouted at everyone to run away from the beach immediately. Her mother felt Chili must be right and they should heed her warning. So what happened later on? Let's listen in the next video.